There have been certain bands throughout the ages that have endured and have filled many of their fans with joy. And one of them is without a doubt, the Eagles. This is a group that has been playing their songs for decades and have had numerous hit songs and albums. But what is it about this group that has allowed such success? And how have their band members fared over the years? Allow us to show you the Eagles, then and now. Be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Eagle Formation. See what we did there? Okay, we'll move on. The Eagles began in early 1971, when Linda Ronstadt and her then-manager John Boylan recruited local musicians Glenn Frey and Don Henley for her band. Henley had moved to Los Angeles from Texas with his band Shiloh to record an album produced by Kenny Rogers, and Frey had come from Michigan and formed Long Branch Penny Whistle. They had met in 1970 at the Troubadour in Los Angeles and became acquainted through their mutual record label, Amos Records. Randy Meisner, who had been working with Ricky Nelson's backing band, the Stone Canyon Band, and Bertie Leadon, a veteran of the Flying Burrito Brothers, also later joined Ronstadt's group of performers for her summer tour promoting the Silk Purse album. While on the tour, Frey and Henley decided to form a band together and informed Ronstadt of their intention. Frey later credited Ronstadt with suggesting Leadon for the band and arranging for Leadon to play for her so Frey and Henley could approach him about forming a band together. They also pitched the idea to Meisner and brought him on board. These four played live together behind Ronstadt only once for a July concert at Disneyland, but all four appeared on her eponymous album. It was later proposed that J.D. Souther should join the band, but Meisner objected. The four were signed in September 1971 to Asylum Records, the new label started by David Geffen, who was introduced to Frey by Jackson Browne. Geffen bought out Frey's and Henley's contracts with Amos Records and sent the four to Aspen, Colorado to develop as a band. Having not settled on a band name yet, they performed their first show in October 1971 under the name of Teen King and the Emergencies at a club called The Gallery in Aspen. The idea of naming the band Eagles came during a peyote and tequila-influenced group outing in the Mojave Desert. Accounts of the origin of the name, however, vary. Don Felder, who had yet to join the Eagles and was not at the desert, credited Leadon with originating the name when he recalled reading about the Hopis' reverence for the eagle, while J.D. Souther suggested that the idea came when Frey shouted out, "Eagles!" when they saw eagles flying above. Steve Martin, a friend of the band from their early days at the Troubadour, recounts in his autobiography that he suggested that they should be referred to as the Eagles, but Frey insists that the group's name is simply Eagles. Either way, they came together, and they would make quite an impact on the world when they started making their music. A career that spanned many decades, even if they didn't realize it would be like that at first. Their first music. Their first album was made over in England all the way back in 1972. One of their producers noted how incredible it was how they harmonized with one another, the true marking of a great band. And said producer was the one who decided to use those great voices to create a country rock band that could best use them in order to make special songs that would resonate with people. When they released said first album, simply titled Eagles, it was an immediate hit. Not just in terms of their album sales, but the fact that three of their singles were in the top 40, including one of their most recognizable songs in Take It Easy.
Well, I'm running down a road trying to loosen my load. I got seven women on my mind.
Though, ironically, it only reached number 12 on the charts, one of the other singles from the track reached number 9 ahead of it. For their second album, they went and made Desperados, which was meant to parody how they were modern rockers and yet outlaws in their own right. And it was during the making of this particular album that Henley and Frey began collaborating. They co-wrote 8 of the album's 11 songs, including Tequila Sunrise and Desperado, two of the group's most popular songs. They had a good thing going, but ironically, they decided they needed a change, changing the sound. As they went to do their third album, they wanted to lean more into the hard rock style, versus the country rock they had done with their two albums before. This actually was a struggle for them, because at first, they only made two good songs. Not exactly good for what's supposed to be a veteran group at this point. However, after switching producers and bringing in what would be their fifth band member in Dan Felder, they were able to make the music that they wanted, which was proven when their third album, On the Border, gave them their first number one track via Best of My Love. And their fame started to really grow from there, and they were seen as very big attractions in the music world. The band played at the California Jam Festival in Ontario, California on April 6, 1974, attracting more than 300,000 fans and billed as the Woodstock of the West Coast. The festival featured Black Sabbath, Emerson, Lake and Palmer, Deep Purple, Earth, Wind and Fire, Seals and Crofts, Black Oak, Arkansas, and Rare Earth. Portions of the show were telecast on ABC television in the US, exposing the Eagles to a wider audience, something that helped them as they continued to make their hit music. One of these nights. If you think about musical artists in the grander sense, one of the things that they want to do is go and get better and get more attention with every album they do. And with One of These Nights, their fourth album, they did just that, because it was through this album that they breached the international market and started getting a lot of attention from around the world. Their hits kept coming, with the titular being another number one hit, and Frey even saying that this was his favorite song that the Eagles made. The second single was Lion Eyes, which reached number two on the charts and won the band their first Grammy for Best Pop Performance by a Duo or Group with Vocal. The album itself was nominated for Album of the Year at the Grammys, and while it didn't win, it was a huge honor, no doubt. Sadly, their fourth album caused a division within the band, as Leadon would soon leave and he would be replaced by Joe Walsh. Continued success. Despite the loss of Leadon and some shuffling around by the band itself, the Eagles continued to rock on. In early 1976, the band released their first compilation album, Their Greatest Hits, 1971 to 1975. The album became the highest-selling album of the 20th century in the United States, and has since sold 29 million copies in the US, excluding streams and tracks, and 42 million copies worldwide. Because of that album, they were dubbed the most successful band in America for the entire decade. Think about that. What followed were more hit songs and albums like Hotel California, which was again nominated by the Grammys for things like Best Record of the Year. But the tension between the band continued to grow, and what's more, they found it harder to make songs together. The Long Run, for example, took 2 years to make, and by 1980, they had broken up. Away and Reunion. Usually, when major bands break up, only one or two achieve success. But in the case of the Eagles, they were all honestly really talented, and many of them had successful hit tracks and solo albums. Fast forward to 1994, and Travis Tritt, of all people, got the Eagles to reunite for a cover of Take It Easy. And the band joked that they didn't break up, but were on a 14-year hiatus. Not inaccurate, per se. Legacy. In the years that followed, the Eagles made more songs and hit albums. Lost members like Frey, had breakups, reunited, did a concert on ESPN of all places, and continued to be the band that endured no matter what. They've been honored in various ways and will forever be one of the most beloved bands in history. They never really did heed their own advice to take it easy, but when they were together, yeah, they flew. What do you think of this look at the Eagles and how the band and its members have done over the years? Are you surprised by how well they've done? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on the channel.